also interesting for us to remember is that after January, in February, that somewhere around the middle of February, there was a celebration that was known by the ancient Romans as the Lupercalia. And the Lupercalia was a ceremony, and Luper means wolf. And they depicted a wolf chasing a little girl. And so the Lupercalia was the celebration of the wolf. And the authorities there would gather together young people, and they would put their names into a box, men and women, and they would take out the names, and whoever was your partner for the day, and all types of sexual activity went on during that day. They were totally out of control. That is the Lupercalia. Now, around February 14th, around 270 AD of the Christian era, a bishop by the name of Valentine, he was trying to work with the Roman soldiers because the Roman emperor had imposed upon his soldiers that anybody who joined the army could not get married. Because if you got married, you're thinking about your wife all the time, and you're a useless soldier. But the soldiers wanted to get married, so Saint Valentine worked with them, and he was captured by the Roman emperor, he was imprisoned, and he was beheaded. And so a legend formed around Saint Valentine's Day. In one case, it said he even helped a blind young girl. He was trying to help her get married. And so she wrote a note, and it was found in his jail cell, "To my Valentine." And so now you have Valentine's Day.